Hey guys, it's pretty quick. Do A start online and do B start online. They're all right there. Do A will start right now and do B will start in 15:36. So yeah, have fun. Happy Thanksgiving, I guess. Well, this is New York. This is a beautiful place. Is any man gonna die as that pace car actually darts off with the biggest lead start ever? That fits the pace car. And you must hit the wall, I guess. Well, anyway, guys. We are green here at New York! Yes, already that quick. And Jason Evans got the best start in history ever in my entire life. And he's actually breaking it off with a Boost Autosport 1-2. I do believe there's two Boost Autosports in this duel. Wow. And, but just letting you know, this is the final race before Indianapolis, by the way. So yeah, these drivers are going to push for the hardest. Well, actually no, there's actually three of them. Three Boost Autosports cars. As again, a leaderboard here after two laps. Jason Evans pulling off a lead here. I'm not surprised. But Baron Praxis and Paul Swanson here. Interesting fact to see as Kit Pitt, the 58-year-old rookie. Yes, no joke. Is trying to battle against Skyler Johnson for fourth. Gee, he got the inside and he is cleared. Oh, nope. Kirby's actually fighting back. And then that Kirby, Skyler Johnson. Wrong female. And Pitt manages to get it done. As could have run this. Oh, no, never mind. We're going for a crossover, shall we? Nope, it did not work as Runders actually got the outside now. Wow. And Runders is much faster at the back straight than Johnson was. But however, Johnson was able to hold off Runders. Now she got fend off against Hulbert. So Skyler Johnson is getting a piece of action here and she will fend off both Hulbert and Runders. Interesting battle there. Ingrid is battling against DeJean Reeks, who's in the top 10. Not having the best season so far, but he's actually making it on the short tracks. As Jason Evans has broken away from Baron Praxis and Paul Swanson. I think Kit Pitt might have a shot against Jason Evans if he actually gets him faster. As there are not laps here, so keep that in mind. We got lap cars. So we will see lap cars. God knows when, probably around the end of the race. Namgi is having the time of his life. And here's Kirby. Not the best run, but however though, she does have a decent gap though. 28 points. She sits at 17, so that's I cannot do math. I shouldn't go 3-1 on run this, not on the Stratus and Kaoshai Jr. She passed Stratus, but can she pass Shock Jr.? And she will be passing both. No, Shock Jr. is trying to fight back, but nope. Shock Jr. got challenged from Miller. As Sanford is ahead of Kirby, not by a lot. Craig actually is not the big winner here so far. Kind of gain positions here. He starts in 17th and he's up to 11th, trying to catch up. As the Jean Reeks battle against Strip Angers, our Seattle winner, after one of the quickest races we see in the Junior Series, and DeJean Reeks passes like he's a damn veteran. But Angers is trying to look, but instead it'd be Nathan Dryer spoiling the party with his arch rival from last season, Ray Krager. Craig's trying to go 3-1, but that's a terrible idea. But how about Dryer blocks? But Dryer now lets Krager to get to his outside. Ingles is struggling to fend off against Krager and Dryer. That's going to cause him a position here. Ingles is trying to dive bomb the corner, but however though, he will not get the preferred line as Nathan Dryer gets his position. as Craig is battling against Ingles for 10th, following Henry Sanford. Another championship contender here. Those are two championship contenders here. Oh lordy, oh wow, I thought Sanford will actually get into the back of the 17. Speaking of the top 10 of points, the top 10 of points has been pretty wacky over the past couple of races. As Jason Nevin has seriously dominated this race so far after 20 races. I mean, not races, rounds. As Hobart is just keeping it chilling, I guess. Fastest lap, who got fastest lap, honestly? That'd be Curtis Vundis, who sets a 15.059. Interesting lap time by Curtis Vundis. He might be a big threat. I always said he's actually a big threat someday, and he's up here. But however though, he needs to get working on his big oval stuff. I think he's good at the road courses too, so. As we already pushed the lap cars already at that number 24, approximately around 24, 25, pretty soon here at least. Yeah, 24. So Jason Evans now has to give a Catholic Young, who's having a season of a lifetime, in a slow looking car here, and you better give him the room, and Young has to give him the room there. That's good. As Bama passes his teammate, is looking forward to get past Catholic Young as well. And Kit Pitt sits in third place. And Bama Praxis will get through Catholic easily. But not Stratus. He's starting in second place. He falls back to 20th. Wow, what happened with him, honestly? And Kirby stuck in 15th. As Henry Sanford gets away with 10th. So now, we're not looking at a single fire battle here. Except for passing through lap cars, but that's pretty much it. Unless something really happens, then I really don't know what to expect. Because right now, Jason Evans is now running away with this race right now. I do believe we'll get his second career victory here. For his career, yeah. But I do believe this will be the first of his season. Yeah, it will be his first. And he actually got his second pole, so a perfect 70 will boost him up to the top 10 points. Guaranteed. And yeah, at Evans, he might approach his Stratus and Namgi pretty soon, and maybe McCain. The Masterson car, Paul Swanson's in 6th. Well, actually, he's in 7th. As we got a lap, that's Captain Young being a lap car as always. And nobody's closing on Jason Evans. He's having a blast so far. He's not getting screwed at Austin, but Holbert has a shot. He's faster than Evans, but I don't think it'd be too. But I think it'd be like, I think it'd be too little, too late, honestly. Because right now Evans, he's just kicking a throttle. Unless he gets screwed again by Stratus or Namgi, the yellow man, as I had to call him now, because he's the guy who gets involved with pretty much in almost every single yellow in the race. Like, that's amazing. I never seen a driver that pretty much you could do that. As Evans is getting behind the 7 car of the Nexus of Bernard Stratus, let's see of how Jason Evans would deal with Stratus. Wow, Stratus actually got straight enough speed for once, apparently. A little bit close. It might cost a little bit of time as Kit Pitt actually caught up to the 28 car of Baron Praxis. And Jason Evans have finally got past Bernard Stratus. As for Baron Praxis, he might get challenged by Kit Pitt. But goodness is, folks, there's no cautions though. So this isn't the cookiest race in entire world. This might be the most modern race you're ever gonna see in the Junior Series so far this season. So yeah, folks, you actually got a calm race for once. Unless the second half of the race gets, unless the second duel decides to be on crack cocaine, then I really don't know what to say. Yes, Kit Pitt is seriously looking for that second position here. Oh, he's gonna use the 7 as a pick! Oh, good lordy. And that right there is passes getting screwed. Trying to fight back, but the sad part is Kit Pitt got the preferred line. His runner is battling against Homer for 4th place. And Kit Pitt will get 2nd place here. As it's pretty much all she wrote, a little bit. Yeah, that's pretty much all she wrote now. Because right now, Jason Evans now got a two lap car lead, and nobody's passing Bernard Stratus. Guys, what are you doing? He's not a leader. And Bernard Stratus is going to keep his ground, I guess. And he's going to get passed up by 5 more people. As Vundes is looking for 3rd. For 3rd. And, well, unless, wow, why Kathy Young is so slow? Holy shit! Why the hell is she so slow? She got lapped almost by the entire field. Because I don't remember her. My god, what in the hell? Well, Kathleen Young is having an awful day. Unless Kathleen Young can really screw Jason Evans, then I really don't know what to say. As Vundes, he's making a charge for 3rd place! Thinking Namgi must have did something with it, because Pax is now falling like a rock a little bit, because he's getting boggled by loud traffic. And slotting Holbert for a podium as well. As Vundes is now in 2nd place. No, in 3rd place. Kit Pitt is way off the mark. As Kit Pitt actually gained time for some odd reason. But I don't think it would matter anyway, because Jason Evans has seriously dominated this competition. He has dominated this duel by a long shot. Pitt is not catching up, but it doesn't matter anyway. White flag is not an imp for Jason Evans. Jason Evans will get 70 points. Alyssa Kirby will not get a lot of points. Henry Sanford is in a top 10. Krager, he was trying to get a top 10, but however, he'd be just shy. And Jason Evans, as I said again, will win this race. Dominantly. My gosh, dang. 2 seconds. 2 seconds. That is by far one of the most dominant races I ever saw by someone. In the Junior Series like that, for a short track at least. But it might be a snoozer, but at the first duel for some odd reason, it pretty much happens to me all the time when I should commentate. I also heard a bump. I don't know from who. Oh, wow, anybody pitted. Amazing. Thank you. So that is a lot less of a race of a lifetime. That's probably a good thing too after what happened at Seattle. But anyway, guys, Jason Evans won this race. I do believe this is his 2nd career win of the Junior Series. Then it is Kit Pitt gets 2nd. That's amazing. Curtis Vundes is in 3rd. Mark Holbert is in 4th. He's the highest out of the top 10 in this duel. Ben Praxis is in 5th. Scott Johnson is 6th. 7th is Paul Swanson in the Masterson car. 8th is Nathan Dreyer. 9th is Henry Sanford. Round of top 10 is DeJean Reeks. Nick Norton is 11th. Craig is 12th. Coleman's 13th. Angers finishes 14th. Kirby's in 15th. Somehow, in some way, Kirby, Krager, and Ingrid was not in the top 10 for this race. Amazing. Miller 16, Carl Shire Jr., which by the way, Shelly Motors United went for upgrade and, well, got 17th instead. For some odd reason. Nathan McCain, 18th. Nam Gee, 19th. Stratus, 20th. Kathy Young, sorry. No points for you. So that's a lot less to race. I guess we can go see duel number two. I guess.
May I ask you a question? How in the hell Chris Valentine got the pole? Like, oh my lord, this is the third pole of the season. He has 15 points with the poles in it for the season. Like, oh my gosh. That is seriously, I do believe, like, I'm kind of curious. let's do math real quick. Be 15, nope. 15 divided by 120, which is right now. So in other words, he has about almost 13% of his points are from poles. That's like amazing. My god, that's kind of like a step of a lifetime. I know.
Can we have freaking normal starts here, folks? Thank you. Anyway, guys, we are green here at MIC. Oh my lord, Davison! What in the absolute fuck were you doing? He says he lost like 5 million positions here. He got like a putrid start. What the hell, Davison? He might even score points at that rate. Alyssa Kirby finishes in 10th. I mean, not 10th. She scored 10 points. It means that Brian gotta score a fourth. Score fourth and you get point lead back again. And Brian is now in 5th. Like, wow. And somehow Jeff Davison is back to normal. Somehow. As Valentine, he just shoots off like a fucking rocket. Holy shit. Well, he might be his first career win here, maybe. I do believe Valentine has not won a race, I think. I don't know. I don't have my sheet with me in. Oh my god. Brian is just shooting like his figure tomorrow here. Holy crap. And Brian is now looking for fourth. Brian is now your new points leader. Holy crap. Brian has now passed up Alyssa Kirby in the points. He's trying to pass up Alyssa Kirby in the points. And he does so. Holy crap. This is another points. There's another points leader change. I do believe this is I believe the 5th or 6th point lead change in season. That's like amazing. But how though, can he actually maintain that point lead? To actually make it official. That's because Valentine, he might get challenged by John Lightning. Even though he's actually 1.65 seconds away, he has a shot. Oh my lord. Oh my lord. What in the hell the SV cars are doing? They're trying to go 3-1 on Binky, both inside and out, but Binky somehow passes through. Oh my god, that's like a talent moment for a little bit. And then Sam Young might get challenged by Binky herself. Yippee. Here's Kazuki Takamoto, Peter Sparrow, James Dolan. Mitch Sims is not fun, but hey, at least he's actually getting points. At least so far, unless he chokes himself to death. And Davison now drops back to 9th. As Tamara Dolise is now in 7th. She started in, I believe that's, that is she. She starts in last place, by the way. And she, what? Oh my lord! She almost pulled 15 seconds! Oh my lord! She can get her, she does have a good shot to get her second career win. I say that for sure. Bruno is going after Bryant. New with Lightning, they're just starting by themselves. Lightning's trying to catch up. New if he's actually not on par with the field behind him. I thought the moment where the Epic Pause is actually faster, that could move for a little bit. That would be too sad. It feels like I see a tire streaks.
I'm not too sure. As Valentine have already caught up to the lap car at lap number 15. Just to know, by the way, Jason Evans actually caught up to Kathy Young at lap number 24. So right now, Valentine is now having like a day of a lifetime for him. But the gap is closing slowly, even without Michael Cavanaugh's shit happening. Cavanaugh is trying to do something. But just let them go. And the next lap car is Commons, who's like 10 seconds away from Valentine. So Michael Cavanaugh, not having the best day for him, unfortunately. As Pinky trying to battle against Jesse Garcia, that's a battle for a lifetime. Other than that, this is pretty normal racing. As Bruno is still hauling the back of the LC1 car, and also, holy shit! Doliz is up to what? Doliz is up in third place. Holy! Oh my god! Doliz is on fire! Ooh! Oh my god! Doliz has a shot! There's never an ISCC driver who actually starts from last place and wins a race! She could do that! Carl almost did it! But the same gym sees at Shanghai, but Doliz! Can she actually do it at a short track? But yet again, it's a short track, but they're 21 of course, but still! That's still pretty amazing! What? She booked 14 seconds! Not 14 seconds, 15 seconds! She booked 15 seconds! No one was able to figure do that as duel! She's legitimately having a shot! Lightning is closing in ever so slowly, but Doliz is closing quick. She needs to get past her teammate, and she will do so. It seems like Doliz is closing in every tenth of a lap, but she actually lost time because trying to pass the Cavanaugh. It's being a bit close though. By the end of this race, she's only going to be 0.8 seconds away. So Doliz doesn't have enough to win. But Lightning, he's closing in everything he can. Unless we get a lot of shenanigans going on. As we got Binky, what do you expect about Binky? I would not be too shocked if Binky would actually change the entire race. Oh, that's my phone. Let's go see it. It's trying to pass out of Sam Young. I saw that battle. And that is an easy battle. Nope, Sam Young is trying to dive bomb his way through. But Sam Young will be going to the outside. Nope. Trying to hang on. Trying to at least. And yep. There goes the battle. At least Vince Simmons is actually running the points. Hey, he's actually getting, like, I believe, 16 points. That's actually more he actually got than the entire season. And not only that, Coma score point. So yeah, sorry, Simmons, you still be sucking. Actually, no, Sam Young. No. Actually, no, Ben Simmons will still be in last place in the points. So yeah, Ben Simmons enjoying last place. Also Christopher Bryant. What in the hell happened? You jumped for figure fours. Now you could lose the damn top 10 position here. Bruno's the same way too. What caused him to do that? Maybe Yoshizawa, but I don't know. But Komori is now up here. As we got a lap cause now. Where in the hell is Valentine? He just passed the Binky in Commons. Oh my lord. Can Sam Young block because Valentine? At the worst time ever. Valentine, do not joke!
Not a joke. This race is kind of almost a given. Oh my word! Tamara Dolise is closing in. She's within 1.5 seconds. Valentine! No, not Valentine. Lightning! Pass up Binky! Oh my word! He just hauled the back of Binky! Threw the back straight away! Good lord! Oh my god, with 15 to go! Valentine is getting a little bit nervous here, I think. Maybe not for Lenny, but for Dolise. Dolise is trying to lose some pace. Or maybe that was just a, I don't know. Oh my word, Lightning! What are you doing? He almost took out Sam Young. That allows Tamara Dolise to close the gap. Lightning, what were you thinking? That's gonna cost Lightning and Tamara Dolise's time. And now Dolise is now hogging the back of John Lightning. Oh my word. Oh my god. Lightning, what were you thinking? And now Valentine is now getting blocked by Garcia. Valentine, no! Oh my word! I swear to... Oh, good lord! Oh, what's anybody doing? It feels like someone is gonna turn each other, I think. And Matt Simmons is not dropping again. Oh, good lord! This is a terrible situation for Valentine. He needs to get past all these lap cars while fending off against Tamara Dolise, who qualified last. Oh my word! Valentine, do not choke! Oh no! This could be a choke moment! This could be a choke moment! Oh lord! Valentine! He just hauled the back of Ben Simmons! Through a half a lap! That allows Tamara Dolise to close in! What are they doing? Oh lordy! With 6 to go! Tamara Dolise is now within striking distance! I don't get what in the hell the drivers were doing, honking the back of drivers! Valentine did gain some time, but now he's getting past Spawn and his teammate Takamoto! Oh lordy! Tamara Dolise is getting close! Spawn, will he be a big issue? Oh my lord! No! Oh my god! Oh my god! Spawn is holding Valentine up! With 3 to go! Oh my lord! Tamara Dolise is now in the back bumper of the 6th car! Oh my god! They just got an upgrade! And look at this team! Oh my god! 2 to go! No way! No way! Tamara Dolise! Oh my god! I cannot believe what I'm seeing here! Tamara Dolise! The storm is on last place! It's not going for the lead! My foot is on the air for Tamara Dolise! Oh my god! Tamara Dolise! Oh my god! I cannot believe my eyes! A person who qualified last place wins the race, and that person is Tamara Dolise. Oh my god, I cannot believe that. Tamara Dolise was 34 in the points. When the hell? What the hell happened? Valentine just completely choked. Oh my god, Valentine, you just completely choked. He got the pole. That's 5 points. He led the most laps. That's 5 more points. So he gets 60 points. Though that is equal to the raw points and wins. But however, that's 10 extra points. Because Valentine, what the fuck happened with you? He just completely choked.
at the last moment. Oh my lord. I cannot believe what I just saw. Oh my lord. Tamatu Lee's was at least 3.28. Like, she's still in last place. And look at her. She got to W. That's the first win of the season, second in her career. Oh my. That was a race. That finished though. But Valentine, you choked it again. You choked it again. Oh my god. He choked a full spin that season and he does it again. Good job, Valentine. GG. Well, that's it, folks. Let's go to the let's go to point standings real quick. Good lord. Tama Dolis is your base winner. Congratulations, Tama Dolis. But after an upgrade like this one, it really helps. It really helps. Chris Valentine. Sorry. He gets second place. John Lennon gets a third. Max Move gets a fourth. Kamui is up. It gets fifth. F Power is in sixth for some odd reason. But Kato Yoshizawa is in third, and then not third, seventh. Eighth is Marcus Bruno. Roderick Anderson. Yes, Roderick Anderson. I was thinking about a different Anderson. Is eighth, I believe. No, ninth. And my top 10 is Chip Davidson. Christopher Bryant finished 11th. Like, good lord, what? Kazuki Takamoto is 12th. Dalton is 13th. 14th is Peter Spamo. 15th is Jonathan Dreyer. Mitch Simmons is 16th. That's 10 points. So he kind of doubled pretty much what he did. In total. Jesse Garcia is 17th. Sam Young is 18th. Sky Cummins is 19th. Mickey Louie is 20th. And Michael Cavanaro. Welp. Well, anyway, that was a race of a lifetime. at least for this track, at least. But still. My god. So, anyway, you're going to see the first ever ISCC driver getting wins, starting from last place. So, yeah, it is possible to do so. Well, anyway, guys, that's all I got here. Stay tuned for the race at Indianapolis. As we got the Sony 400 with a bunch of legends, and also drivers from this series going to be one of us for the Sony 400 at Indianapolis. Let's hope that no one dies there, because Indianapolis was a crazy track. At least for Sim Jim, yes, it's not crazy, but it just has some nice moments as well. So anyway, guys, I'm Crazy Gordon. I'm gonna see you guys soon. So guys, ta-ta for now.